All right.
So,
got the haircut, beard gone, we're done seeding.
Well, I just got the text from Dad. That means I am done, which really doesn't mean anything. On paper, it means I'm done, but we are not done, so I am not done. Every field I have has been sowed. Currently, I'm probably about 45 acres down. I have a low-lying spot in one of my Durham fields. I checked it out 2 days ago. I still don't think we'll get into it, but I'm gonna go check it out later today as well. I have another, I wanna say it's 22 acres or is it 28? Can't remember. But I think we'll get most of it, or at least half of it. Again, I'll go check it today. So Dad has 300, essentially it's a half section. It's about 320 acres apiece. And it's gotta be close to noon now. Made me a good time. 20 after 10. So by the time he comes here and he gets everything, we'll get loaded up, switched over. We shouldn't have to calibrate. We have every number written down. So we will do that, get him loaded up, and then he'll head up north. And yeah, so it'll be noon by the time he gets moved over here, filled, and then moved up there. Well, if it wasn't such a twisty-turny field and a couple of sketchy spots and I would say potentially we could get done tonight. I don't think we will. I would guess we will likely have that 115 acre parcel on the west side of the road left. We'll do that tomorrow, then we'll be done. And everything will be kosher with crop insurance because we are done everything before the deadlines. This is by far the latest I ever would have thought we'd put in peas. I was gonna do some asking around. I haven't got a chance to. After we get loaded up, I'm gonna run to town or run to Precision. Do some figuring there. After I scout those two wet spots, I would guess we'll be able to put barley on both. They're only about 7 miles apart. So, yeah, that's kind of our situation right now. I'm still guessing we should be done. Should be done tomorrow morning, but then we'll probably do some running around and attempting a couple low spots. So, well, hopefully last night of seeding, and I just got done scouting crops, just checking for flea beetles more than anything, and it's dead calm. So I figured, hey, maybe I should take the drone out. It's the first chance I've had all year, because the nights where I wasn't busy spraying was usually because it was too windy or wet, and obviously had 100 other jobs to do. But we're kind of caught up right now, and I'm just kind of on standby. So let's take her out for a snort before she gets too dark. All right, so stupid me. Didn't realize that I didn't push record on my other phone while I was flying. Now I also know that there's another feature with the drone where it will actually record me talking and embed that audio. So I'm going to use that in the future. But, so we're going to do this maybe picture in picture or voiceover. So right now we just took off. This little green spot below us is a pasture and it's kind of a primary runoff route. We only bought this land 2-3 years ago and we're considering possibly breaking that. It is full of rocks though, so it's going to be a big project to do. It's only like 20 acres, but it'll be a big project and we're going to need to do some contouring.
So we're getting over the main part of the field now. You can see a couple, this kind of wet spot coming up here. That's the spot I hit with the sprayer. I swear it didn't look that wet when I went through it. It splashed up pretty good. So Dad has been working from the south to the north. He did his two laps of the headland. And it's surprisingly, I thought he was going to have to leave a lot more behind here. But he's been bombing right through the wet spot. And you can see that real dark streak in the middle. That was standing water when I sprayed it a couple days earlier. There is some spots that were kind of watery, but not bad. One thing Dad likes to do, and it's really effective, is that he will kick out the shanks. And we call it scuff, or just scraping the product in. What that does is it takes a lot of the... Now, the peas will not get to proper depth a lot of the time because you're taking the down pressure out of it. But the knives do want to pull themselves down into. So it's kind of... You'll probably get most of your depth there, but it takes a lot of the load off the tractor, so he's a lot less likely to spin out. Now, as we get moving forward, you'll see some more of the spots, and this is a really nice byproduct of what we do, where I spray. A lot of times we end up spraying shortly after we seed it, but if I can spray ahead, especially in a wet year like this, Dad can really tell where the wet spots are. I don't like to go directly through if I don't have to, but at the same time, we can get away with it. The sprayer goes through a lot, despite me being stupid in one of the last videos there, and that was just going over a spot I shouldn't, crossing a spot I shouldn't have gone. So you can see this big water run that Dad's approaching right now. I don't recall what Dad did there, whether he seemed to have stopped. He must have spun out there. So I'm doing this a fair bit after the fact. Yeah, so you can see he kicked out the drill. He must have spun out. Sure looks like it. And then just lifted everything and said, nope, I'll just keep on going. So he'll go back afterwards and he'll catch that on his second lap of this wet spot. That water run, it was gouged out. Like, I could have went through it with the sprayer, but it was quite rough. So you can see up here I did, but further up I didn't. Again, it's a real nice that we can get out ahead, and it puts Dad not on edge, kind of the opposite, at some comfort knowing that there's a wet spot coming up, as far as he will, he'll be prepared to kick things out. He's got make sure. Yeah, you can see that was the south end where the sprayer tracks are right there. That's the south end of where I was willing to cross. I went up further north and I didn't even bother trying to go across it. But then 3 or 4 days later, Dad bombed straight through it with the drill. It was soaking up pretty good. So at least Dad is ready. He's got his finger on the hydraulics and he's just, maybe he's not on Twitter. He wouldn't be on Twitter if he's hand steering around stuff. The way he's slowing down there, it looks like he might be powering out. There's that real nasty wet stuff that I didn't even bother going through.
I think Dad's coming this way. I'm guessing he's pretty much done for the night because it's getting slimy where he is. So I'm going to return this guy home. It'll come back over here. There's no rush. We weren't getting done tonight anyways. Holy mosquitoes, just ridiculous. Morning, everybody. So today is June the what, 8th? 8th. What? I'm not sure what that text's all about. Dad is finishing the last field. That's the one I was flying over in the, with the drone last night. Finishing up that. Actually, we got a bit of a late start. That field got some rain last night. Not much, but the stuff along the hills is much tackier dirt, so if it gets a little bit of rain, it really sticks. Like, I was probably walking around an extra 3.5 inches taller. So we were out checking crops. I checked some last night, and the stuff just over here was borderline, I thought, for needing to spray for flea beetles. Dad got out there and said, yeah, we better. I agree, it's borderline, but we better. So I got some pounce. We're gonna nuke them. This stuff is for the flea beetles and flea beetle, well, not flea beetles only, but bugs. I'm not spraying any herbicide. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tweak my rate. I'll talk to it when I'm in about that when I'm in the cab, but I can't really, well, maybe I can. Try and start this up. Figured you would do that. Try and bash a jug one-handed for you. Probably should do it right-handed, but that's my part jug. Worked pretty good, actually. Now, try and do this without launching the... Give a real good rinse. Ugh, stinky. Not as bad as like Malthion or Desis, but stinky nonetheless. If that's not a good enough rinse, I don't know what is. I like this basher. I like the other one too. They both work pretty good. I had to add some zip ties to that one though, because that hose kept coming off. And the hose is loose by design, so that you can pop it free and rinse jugs. But I've added that washdown hose, so it's not really needed anymore, so I tightened it up. Let's get some fluid going. So the flea beetles only like the canola when it's small. In the, they call it the cotyledon phase. And so most of the stuff down south is beyond that. We have one field that's kind of on the border. I'm going to check again this afternoon. But right now is really good conditions for spraying bugs. It's fairly calm and it's warm. They're more active when it's warm. So we'll get some spray down on these guys. Probably enough in the tank to start. Close that, send that. Rinsey, rinsey. I like that rotary sprayer too. It does a really good job of rinsing this out.
I think it's empty. I didn't hear the pump shift.
So here's what flea beetles do. They eat the canola when it's small. All those little yellow spots are bites. You can see there's a bunch of them on this plant. They're called flea beetles because they're little and they jump like fleas. There's black ones and striped ones. I think striped ones are a little bit bigger, but they do.
Yeah. Like, there's a lot of bites to that and a lot of fresh ones. The green ones that haven't changed yet. Not sure how well that's going to come across. Those are fresh. Yeah. So we're going to kill them.
Because they will decimate
stuff.
They only like it when they're small, but yeah, they're getting killed today.
So the big difference between the insecticide that's in the plant and the pounce that we're putting on now, like the Lumiderm, is the insecticide that integrates itself into the plant for the first 30 days-ish. This is a contact killer. So it just needs to get on the bugs and they die. It disrupts their nervous system, they die. The stuff that is in the canola has to be ingested. So it's like a systemic toxin. It works, but if you've got an infestation going on, like, it really helps, like, if you have a small population come in, they're not going to live there for a few days and go through a reproductive cycle. They're just going to die off. It will prevent a second generation from happening. But if you have an infestation, and they get blown around by the wind because they're really small. If they get brought in and there's a lot of them, like there is in this field, they'll destroy the plants before they get too sick, and then you're screwed. So you gotta kill them. The target I'm looking at, try and do this, but for insecticide, which is foliar contact or stomach poison, they want medium or full systemic, medium or coarse. Yeah, so we're looking for medium to coarse. Well, a medium, what they're asking for is essentially 226 to 400, what is that, microns. Looking things up in my trusty Wilger app. So that's at 3.9, which is what we spray our burn off with. You can see it's coarse up to 50, but the higher you are, the more likely you are to get pushed around, etc. So at 50% duty cycle, 35 to 40, I can be right around 14 mile an hour is like perfect. Gives me, but at 6.1, 50% duty cycle at 60 PSI, I'm up into the medium at 11.5 miles per hour, 259 microns, which, oh, there she goes, down on the floor, which gives me almost perfect size for, I think they said, what, 225 is what, 225 to 325, something like that, 225 to 300, whatever I just said like a minute ago. So by
without changing tips and changing the pressure, I can change my application style, in a sense. In the olden days, you would have had you could have done the same thing with the same tips, but to accommodate without the PWM system, this guy, to get the same application rate and smaller droplet size, you have to increase your pump rate and increase your driving speed, which isn't always fun. I like to go fast. I'm Ricky Bobby. I want to go fast, but sometimes it's rough. Sometimes you're constantly turning. Sometimes the hills are uneven and you're always dipping booms down and shit like that. Well, we got done last night. Well, not quite done. We should have got done. We were putting barley in one of the low spots, and we're not really sure why, but we know why we used the calibration number that we did, because it was the same number we used when we did barley last year before, and it was bang on. Like, it was less than a percent error, so we used it. Well, we were targeting 2 bushel, and we put on 4 somehow. So at about 7:30, we ran out of barley. So we had to get some more this morning. So Dad finished that probably 10 minutes ago. But that's why I shaved the beard last night, but I haven't got a haircut yet. So hopefully I can get in for a haircut this afternoon. But we're going to spray for more flea beetles. This field is kind of marginal for flea beetles, but God, just with the price right now, I don't really want to not. And yeah, I'm just waiting on Dad to get down here to pick me up so I can go get the tender trailer. All right, we got the haircut. So that means that we are done, sort of. There's 20 acres on a field over here we might try and take a crack at in a week or so. I want to put something there for two reasons. One, it's already fertilized. We floated last fall. And two, I don't want to lose it to the weeds. So even if I put something like maybe millet. Oh, I got to go around this and it's on my bad side. Well, I might not have to. Definitely going to have to next time. But so, yeah, we'll put something there to grow and then, well, maybe the neighbors can bale it. We'll see. At least then we're competing with the weeds and we're not leaving excess nutrients, let them go to waste. All right, so that was my first fill out of the tender in the field where I didn't have to fold up. I didn't have a lot to mix, so I kind of babied it the first little bit until I had all my mix away. Just kind of wanting to make sure I didn't get ahead of myself, but it was 7:28. I think I can be well under 7-minute mixes.